sisters Bertrille and Jacqueline are at the waterfront buying fish for the convent. They like to go early in the morning to get the best of the day's catch. That's not the best of the day's catch, but she will hide herself in the back of the station wagon.
Sister, does the fish smell differently to you this morning?
Yes, it does.
Spoiled?
No, kind of romantic.
If your fish smells romantic, check the expiration date. Who is she and what's she running from?
Bobby!
You see her?
Who?
Miss Bright Eyes. She's gone.
Maybe she went for a walk.
About at this time of the morning? She took the ice and the skins with her. She couldn't have gotten very far.
Herb Edelman was one of those guys who just never aged. You probably remember him as Stanley's Bornak, Dorothy's goofy ex-husband on Golden Girls. You might also remember that was 20 years after this and he looked exactly the same. It's just not fair that some people can do that and some of us can't. Today he's talking gangster talk. She took the skins and the ice, which is to say the furs and the diamonds. Sidekick saw the purple station wagon and figures whoever owns it helped her get away.
Whoever owns that purple station wagon just better get used to parking it at the bottom of the water.
That probably wouldn't faze them. It's broken down in worse places than that.
Be careful, sister. Oh, it is alive. Oh, we better get help.
Wait a minute. I didn't mean to scare anybody. Nuns.
Her name is Bobby Starr. That's B-O-B-B-Y-E. I don't know why. E.
Do you still give refuge in these places?
Oh, are you in trouble, Miss Starr?
Trouble? No. I just quit my job this morning, and I would like to avoid the gentleman that employed me. He has some very strange ideas about loyalty.
What kind of work did you do?
I was a secretary.
She says, I was a private secretary, if you know what I mean. They don't. As it happens, Sister Anna is sick and Reverend Mother needs a temporary secretary. Bobby is her girl.
Can you tell me how well you take dictation?
I don't know. I've always lived in a democracy.
I foresee trouble.
Who was your former employer?
Mr. Kane.
Mr. Kane?
Mr. Albion Kane.
The name does not strike a familiar note. What line of business is he in?
Mr. Kane? He deals in a service.
We know he's a gangster of some kind because he talks the lingo and all that. We don't know how long she was with him, but listening to her talk, I can believe he tricked her into it. I doubt it was very difficult.
That it?
That's it.
Bring the funny sticks.
He has a strange definition of what's funny.
Who do you think it is, the syndicate?
Dirty pool man.
At least he seems to know when he's outclassed. Dynamite that car and you may find your boat engulfed in lightning bolts. Somehow, I don't think Reverend Mother is going to be excited about having the sexiest smelling typewriter on the island.
Convent San Tonko. God bless you.
Bobby Starr there?
Bobby Starr, what kind of a name is that for a nun?
With whom am I speaking?
Sister Quarantine, stay away.
I'm sure she fooled him.
Miss Starr, you have a visitor. Your brother is here to see you.
I don't have a brother. Oh, yeah, well, give him a message for me, sister. Tell him to drop dead.
She always was the funny one in the family.
What is it, Al?
I want to talk to you.
Okay, maybe she didn't fool him. He's telling her to get over this nonsense and come back.
Pedro. Oh. to spy on people. But sister, I know that man's face. He is a bad man. Of course. He is Dr. Fu Manchu. He's going to destroy the world.
Not taking a child seriously is a big mistake, no matter what the context is. We'll learn that Pedro does a lot of reading in his spare time.
What's bugging you?
You don't value me. That's what's bugging me.
Two mean coats. That don't value you, huh?
Al, if you really loved me, you would get an honest job and you would marry me.
Marry you? And you would pack my lunch pail every morning. Fat chance. Ah, come on, don't tell me you don't like the diamonds and the skins, huh?
Well, I give them all up for a plain band of gold.
That's the trouble with guys like him. They think they can buy whatever or whoever they want, and when they come up against someone who can't be bought or who won't be bought anymore, they don't know what to do. Bobby has been confiding her dilemma to Sister Bertrill, and as usual, Sister Fixit has a plan.
I know what the girls at college used to do. If a fellow was slow to get the message, she'd find somebody else and shake him up.
Of course, she knows the perfect guy for this plan, and he always says yes to her plans.
And Carlos, I know you like her because she's really a great person.
This is why you got me out of bed at 11 o'clock in the morning to help some desperate female trapped husband. What am I to you? A clown? A buffoon?
He complains like a Karen all the way, but he always says yes.
Do you really think I'm going to play this humiliating role?
Now, Carlos,
good morning, sister.
Oh, good morning, Miss Star.
This is the lady.
Mm-hmm.
Miss Star, allow me to introduce myself. Carlos Ramirez, clown and buffoon.
And sometimes it turns out well for him. He doesn't want to pretend. He wants to woo her for real.
Allow me to quote from our beloved Puerto Rican poet, Domingo J. Domingo. La pluma de mi tía está en la mesa. English translation, great laughs from little capers grow.
That must be what it means in Puerto Rican Spanish. In regular Spanish, it means my aunt's pen is on the table. Now Sister Bertrill isn't sure what it means.
Hey, sure sky right funny down here. No plane.
Sure it's a plane. It's just high up, that's all.
Carlos has picked up Bobby and taken her to his boat, where he's ready to declare that he's genuinely fallen for her and she should dump Al and stay with him. Al has different ideas.
Do you think we'd be betraying a confidant, sister?
I don't know.
It's just that I don't want to see Miss Star fall in with the wrong sort of people.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. She's such a helpless little bird. Come on, sister. Who is he?
After a sufficient amount of hemming and hawing around, they let it slip that his name is Carlos Ramirez and he's probably on his yacht, the Caprice. And he's most likely hoping to rename it the Fornication Ferry.
Sisters! Sisters! Finally I remember where I saw that man.
Where, 007?
He is Big Albion King, the Terror of Chicago.
His most common nickname is Mr. Vicious. Sister Bertrill has to fly over to Carlos's yacht before Big Al gets there.
It is the beauty I see in you, so.
Oh, Carlos, no one's ever noticed the real me before.
Carlos! Carlos!
Excuse me, my love.
Carlos!
He doesn't want to hear it. He locks all the doors, makes sure all the shades are tightly closed, and turns the music up to the point where they can't hear each other.
Open up, Ramirez! Is that your friend?
That's him.
Don't worry. I will deal with him.
I'm gonna count to three!
Carlos, I better tell you who he is.
What? Introductions aren't necessary.
Oh, yeah? You ever hear of Big Al Kane from Chicago?
Who? Mr. Vicious?
Uh-huh. Three!
Carlos gets the door open just in time. Big Al is ready to empty that revolver into him.
Listen, slave boy, by the time I'm finished with your face, your own mother won't recognize you.
Don't worry, Carlos. I'll come
what
every
cops?
Day
what
to the
cops?
Hospital
what
and
cops?
Do
cops? What cops?
Dumb, Mr. Vicious, you and your temper. This isn't gambling. This isn't running a book. This is big trouble, and you're gonna get life.
dumped this.
Well, where?
Somewhere.
It's not yours, Mr. Kane. I have a witness.
When Sister Bertrille saw Al coming, she flew away and called the police. Big Al is in big trouble, but Carlos has a way he can get out of it.
Of course, a wife cannot testify against her husband.
Are you all right? Well, Sergeant, what started out as a possible homicide seems to have turned into a definite matrimony.
Big Al did marry Bobby, but initially he refused to go into a different line of work. 2 months of non-stop nagging and eating nothing but Spam sandwiches changed his mind. Being a gangster, he had to find something he was good at, so he got into Congress and lived happily ever after. You had to know that was coming. If you enjoyed this, please click the like button to let me and YouTube know you want to see more. If you're not subscribed yet, punch me in the mask here and get signed up so you don't miss a thing, because something is always happening here at Irving Zoo. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. That's not the best of the day's catch. As it happens, Sister Anna is sick and Reverend Mother needs a temporary replacement. Let's take out replacement, because obviously I can't say that word. The mouse works better when you hold it frontwards.